to the class. This is me, Deepa, your computer teacher. I hope you all are fine at your home. Let's start today's class. Before starting today's class, let's take a quick recap of the previous class.
Good morning, everyone. Let's continue today's class. As you know that our chapter Notepad is going on, so let's start today's class. First, we have to open Notepad. To open Notepad, we have to click on Start button. Now, I hope you all are familiar with Start button. As you know that Start button is on the left-hand side of taskbar. The bottom, lowest bottom bar is known as taskbar. At the left-hand side of the taskbar, we have Start button, and at the right-hand side of the taskbar, we have System tray. So we have to click on Start button and then All Programs and Accessories. And then click on Notepad. This is our Notepad window. The topmost bar is known as title bar. At the right hand side, we have three control buttons: minimize, restore, and close button. Now you all know very well the work of these three buttons. Minimize button is used to minimize the size of window. When we use minimize button, our window will shrink and fit into the taskbar. This is our restore button. When we use restore button, it will replace with maximize button. And to exit from the notepad, we have to click on close button. Okay. And these are the tabs: file, edit, format, view, and help. These five tabs are available in notepad. In the previous class, we learned how to open the already saved file, how to save our new file, and how to exit from the notepad window. And as you know that this white area is known as working area, and this blinking line is known as cursor. So let's quickly recap all the things which we have done in the previous class. First, let me write something for you. In the previous class, we learned how to save our file. Save option is available in File tab. So we have to click on Save option, and then we have to write the name of our file. As you know that TXT is the extension of Notepad, and as I told you that extension is the identifier of a particular file. With the help of extension, we get to know the file is related to which application, whether it is of Notepad, of WordPad, or related to MS Word, etc. So first we have to give the name to the file. Like this. And then we have to click on Save button. Now I am going to close the Notepad window by using Close button. Now I'm on desktop. After closing the notepad window, I want the previous file which I have saved earlier again. Then I have to open notepad like this. And then we have to choose open option. Children, just remember that I want to open the already saved file. So I have to choose open app option from the file menu. So click on file menu and then choose open option, and then choose your file and then click on open button. Now you can see that our previous saved file is here. New open save as are the option which we can get from file menu. Okay, all these things we have done in our previous class. In today's class, we will learn some options of edit menu. Edit menu is the next menu of file menu. Undo, cut, copy, paste, delete, find, find next, replace, go to, select all, date and time are options are available in edit menu. Today we will learn how to move and how to make a duplicate copy of a selected text. It means today we will learn how we can move our selected text from its original place to the new place and how we can make a duplicate copy of a selected text. Okay, as I told you in so many time that when you want to do anything on your text, first you have to select your particular text. I mean to say that selection is very important to do any operation on any text or object. So we are going to learn how to move our text. First we have to choose the text with the help of mouse like this. This blue area denotes that our this line is selected. Now we are going to learn how we can cut this selected text. So first selection is there, and then we have to move towards edit menu and then click on cut option. Now you can see that our selected matter is cut. The matter is cut, not delete. Okay, just mind that. Just remember one thing, that there is a difference between cut and delete. Here we have used cut option. It means our cut matter is saved in clipboard. Clipboard is the temporary area. Okay, in clipboard all the cut and copied matter are stored for a short time. Now I want that cut matter here. So first we have to place the cursor on the desired place where we want our cut matter. Okay, just suppose that I want this cut matter here only. Now go to edit menu and choose paste option. You can see that your cut matter is here. Okay, it means our text is moved from its original place to new place. Now I'm going to write another line. This one. Now we are going to perform copy option. Okay, so first we have to select the text like this. I want this option, this line here also. It means this line should be there and on this place also. So first we have to select this line with the help of mouse and then go to edit menu and use copy option and then click on the new place and use paste option like this. Now you can see that the previous text is here along with the new one. The previous text is here on its original place and the copied text is here on its new place. Now I hope you can understand the basic difference between cut and copy option. I would like to repeat both the things again. Cut, with the help of cut option, the selected matter will move from its original place and it will paste on its new place. But with the help of copy option, the original place, the original text will remain on its original place along with its new place. Okay, I hope everything is clear about cut and copy. Now we are going to learn how we can delete the selected matter with a single click. First we have to select the matter which we want to delete. Okay, this is the selection, and then we have to move to edit menu and then select delete option like this. Now our text is deleted. Okay. Let me revise you all the things once again. First, we have to open Notepad. I hope now you all can open Notepad easily. And then we have to write something on the Notepad window. Like this. And then if I want to cut this matter, select and then add it and then use cut option. Place the cursor where you want the cut matter like this. It means the new place and then use paste option. This is the use of cut. And if you want to use copy option, first you have to write something which you want to copy. Now I want to copy this matter. So what I have to do? Yes, I have to select the text and then move towards edit menu and choose copy option and then place the cursor on the desired place like this and then add it and then use paste option like this. Now you can see both the lines are here, new one along with the old one. And to delete all these lines or all the text, select it and then click on edit menu and then choose delete option like this. Your text is deleted. I hope everything is clear to you. Now let's continue today's classwork, chapter number 7, Notepad. Phillips, and the first question is, Bash is a program used to type text in a document. Our options are Paint and Notepad. As we know that Paint is used for drawing and Notepad is used to make a text or a document. So the answer of the question will be Notepad, and we have to write Notepad here. Second question is, Notepad is found in Dash folder, text or accessories. So we all know that Notepad is found in accessories folder. So the answer of this question will be accessories. Third question is, Dash are the different styles used for typing font or text. As we know that font are used to type the text in different styles. So the answer of the question is font. Next is, clicking on the dash button takes us to the accessories folder, start or shutdown. Answer is start. Now answer the following. Question number 1. What do you mean by Notepad? Answer is, Notepad is a text editing program which is used to type simple text. This is all about today's class. I hope you all enjoyed the class. If you have any problem, you can call me. And as you complete your work, please send it to me. Thank you.